If one person has a bat and the other person has a ball, can they play cricket alone?
No, only when they decide to share the bat and the ball, only then they can play cricket.
Similar is the case with some atoms. At times, they like to share electrons. For example, hydrogen. Hydrogen has one electron in the valence shell. In order to have the duplet structure, it needs one more electron in the valence shell. So it shares one electron with other hydrogen atom. So when both the hydrogen atoms share one electron each, now this hydrogen atom has a duplet structure and this hydrogen atom has a duplet structure. So by sharing one electron each, both the hydrogen atoms are stabilized. This can also be shown in this form. When we write it in this manner, we only show the valence electrons. So now in this case, this hydrogen has one valence electron, this hydrogen has one valence electron, both of them share these electrons. So now, these two electrons are shared by both the hydrogen atoms. So now they both have duplet structure and they have a stable electronic configuration. Now we can also represent this in another manner. We can show a bond between the two hydrogen atoms. This single bond shows that there are two electrons shared between the two atoms. Whenever there is a single bond, it shows that two electrons are being shared by the two atoms and each atom in this case is contributing one electron. So in this case, each atom contributes equal number of electrons. And such type of compounds which are formed are known as covalent compounds. Covalent because it means that the valence electrons are together. This means they are sharing the valence electrons. And hence, these compounds are named as covalent compounds. And the type of attraction between the atoms is the intermolecular attraction. So in ionic compounds, the type of attraction between the two ions is electrostatic force of attraction. In case of covalent compounds, the type of attraction between the two atoms is intermolecular attraction. So the covalent compounds are formed by the sharing of electrons. These are the chemical compounds which are formed by sharing of electrons. Ionic compounds are the chemical compounds formed by the transfer of electrons. Covalent compounds are the chemical compounds formed by the sharing of electrons. Let's take another example. We have chlorine atom. Chlorine has 7 electrons in the valence shell. Now it needs one more electron to satisfy the octet rule. So it shares one more electron with another chlorine atom. Now in this case, both the chlorine atoms are short of one electron. So they share one electron. When they share one electron each, now each chlorine atom has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Each chlorine atom has 8 electrons. Both of them satisfy the octet rule and hence they form a covalent compound. This can also be represented by this. We write the chemical and we show the valence electrons. So each chlorine atom has 7 valence electrons. They share one electron. This is also represented by drawing a single covalent bond between the two atoms. Whenever we see a single covalent bond, that means two electrons are being shared by the two atoms. So this is a covalent compound. Let's do a question here. Covalent compounds are formed by the sharing of electrons, transfer of electrons, sharing of protons or transfer of protons. We know that covalent compounds are the chemical compounds that are formed by sharing of electrons. In this, the electrons, the valence electrons, as the name suggests, are shared between the atoms. In case of ionic compounds, the electrons are transferred from one atom to another. In case of covalent compounds, the electrons are shared between the two atoms.
So covalent compounds involve the sharing of electrons. Let's take another example. We have oxygen atom. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons. It is short of 2 electrons. Now it combines with another oxygen atom. Both the oxygen atoms are short of 2 electrons. So they share 2 electrons. How do they do this? So now each oxygen atom is sharing 2 electrons with the other oxygen atom. In the process, this oxygen atom has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And similarly, the other oxygen atom has 8 electrons. So by sharing 2 electrons each, both the oxygen atoms now have the octate structure. This is a covalent compound. And we can also represent it in the other manner. That is, we write the chemical oxygen and we show the number of valence electrons. Now, 2 electrons are shared between the 2 atoms. So we show that each oxygen atom is sharing 2 electrons with the other oxygen atom. So how can we represent this? We can also represent it in this manner. We know one covalent bond shows that there are 2 electrons shared between the 2 atoms. In this case, there are 4 electrons being shared between the 2 atoms. So in order to represent these 4 electrons, we make a double covalent bond. So in this case, each bond has 2 electrons. So it shows that 4 electrons are being shared between the 2 atoms. Let's take an example of nitrogen. Nitrogen has 5 valence electrons. So in order to complete the octet, it needs 3 more electrons. It combines with another nitrogen atom. Now both the nitrogen atoms are short of 3 electrons. So they share 3 electrons each. How do they do this? Now this nitrogen atom shares 3 electrons with the other nitrogen atom. So it has 3 plus 3, 6, 7, 8. 8 electrons. Similarly, the other nitrogen atom has 8 electrons. So by sharing 3 electrons each nitrogen atom completes the octate structure. We can also represent this as nitrogen showing the number of valence electrons. Now they are sharing 3 electrons. Now total number of electrons being shared between the 2 atoms is 6. So we represent this by a triple bond. We know a single bond shows that 2 electrons are being shared between the 2 atoms. In this case, 6 electrons are being shared between the 2 atoms. So we represent this by a triple covalent bond. So depending on the number of electrons being shared between the 2 atoms, we can show the number of covalent bonds. Let's take an example where there are 2 different kind of atoms. So in this case, we have hydrogen atom, which has 1 valence electron, and chlorine, it has 7 valence electrons. In this case, both the atoms need 1 electron each. Hydrogen needs 1 electron to have the duplet structure, and chlorine needs 1 electron to have the octet structure. So even in this case, when there are different kinds of atoms, even they can share electrons. So in this case, both the atoms share 1 electron each. So now hydrogen has the duplet structure and chlorine has the octet structure. Even this we can represent it in this manner, since they are sharing 2 electrons. So we can represent this by a single covalent bond. So this is also a covalent bond being formed between the hydrogen and the chlorine atom. Let's take another example. How is water formed? Water is a compound of hydrogen and oxygen. So if we take 1 atom of hydrogen and 1 of oxygen, if it shares 1 electrons with oxygen, hydrogen now has the duplet structure. But oxygen will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 electrons. It is still short of 1 electron. So it further shares 1 electron with another hydrogen atom. So oxygen, in order to satisfy the octet rule, shares electrons with 2 hydrogen atoms. So now both the hydrogen atoms have a duplet structure and oxygen has an octet structure. So by sharing one electron with each of the hydrogen atoms, oxygen is also stabilized and the two hydrogen atoms are also stabilized. So water is a covalent compound, which is also represented by this. We show the valence electrons and we see that two electrons are being shared between each of the two atoms. So we can represent this by two single bonds, one between this hydrogen and oxygen and one between this hydrogen and oxygen. So depending on the number of electrons being shared, we show the number of covalent bonds. So covalent bonds or covalent compounds are the compounds which are formed by the sharing of electrons. And the type of attraction between the atoms in a covalent compound are the intermolecular forces of attraction.